Okay, this is another recipe I've got. Marrow fat peas. It have to be marrow fat, not garden peas or processed peas. It's going to be marrow fat peas. Garlic, loads and loads of garlic. If you don't like garlic, don't use garlic. Just the peas and tomato ketchup. Not tomato puree, not tomato sauce. Tomato ketchup. The cheap one is ideal. Okay, we have to chop the garlic up, but not very fine. Okay, so this is how I usually chop my garlic up. But you can put it in a mincer and mince it up, but not too fine. Just mince it coarsely, because you need to have it not stewed. Okay, right. This is it. Right. Okay, there you go. Right. That's loads of garlic. The more garlic you have, the tastier it is. But as I said, if you don't like garlic, don't use garlic. Okay, that's the garlic done. Now we have to open the tins. Just get a tin. Okay. Matter of fact, I'm going to open the tin of peas. Just open those tins. Now we have to drain it to get the liquid off of it. Okay, drain it. Well, I've got three tins in here. That's three tins of marrow fat peas. The next thing, leave that to drain. The next thing we do is, if you come over here, we have to put a tiny drop of oil in. That's enough, can you see? It's not a lot, just enough there. Just to brown the garlic. But that's hot. Get that nice and hot, and then, we take the garlic. It's good idea to get everything ready. Okay, get it in there. Put all the onion, the garlic in. And grab the garlic. And then, spoon. One minute. Okay. Stir the garlic. You see that? Get that brown, not too brown because it's going to get bitter. Just a light brown colour. Okay, can you see the colours in that? Okay, now the next thing we do is you have to add tomato sauce. Tomato ketchup, sorry, not sauce, tomato ketchup. I put quite a lot in. Oh, go on, bang it in. Half a bottle. Yep, that's good, nice. And then, nice. Okay. So mix that in. Let the tomato ketchup heat through. And let that heat through. And so as soon as it gets a little bit hot, heats up. Just let the sauce heat through. Okay. While this is heating, because I grow my own herbs, I'm just going to go and get some fresh herbs very quickly. So if you come with me, right. A little bit of sage. A little bit of tarragon, thyme, some parsley, and some sage again, some rosemary. See? That's all you need, just a little bit, okay? This is all ready. See, look, that's bubbling very nicely. Now, take your peas, add your peas to that, and stir it in. Don't mash it up, leave it whole. Just turn it over so the sauce coats the peas. And just leave it to, not to cook, but just to heat through. If you have a look at my chickpea recipe, it's exactly the same. Everything is cooked, but you're just heating everything through. Okay, and once that's heated through, all you have to do is test it. Take one. It's still a bit cold, so leave it to heat through. When it's hot, sprinkle a little bit of herbs in there, like that. You can chop it up small if you want the herbs. If you don't have fresh herbs, use dried herbs. But just a little bit, not a lot, just a tiny bit. See, that's all ready, that's nice and hot. See, that's nice and hot, it's bubbling. I tasted one thing, bubbling. Okay, now what we have to do is take it out of the pan and we put it in a bowl. And don't forget, this goes lovely with roast, any roast dinner. Fish is beautiful fish. Or you can have it make a sandwich out of it. Or just have it in the salad if you like. But it's very nice. But it's, you're going to use the marrow-fat peas. There you go. All done.